Ski mountaineering trip to really come together, there's three things that have to work out pretty well. One is that the weather needs to be cooperating. Also, the conditions need to be right. And lastly, you have to have the right team, the right group, pulling it off together, all with the same objectives. Here you can see the running snow water equivalent for Mammoth Mountain since 1982, 618.5 inches. Of snowfall, and that's crushing the record here since 1970.
Topographic maps are a critical tool for route planning.
I've always waited for the right season and the right time to maybe come down in here, and I was particularly interested in exploring this southern part of the Black Divide around Jebel's Crags. There's this obvious ski feature that we really wanted to look at. So we wanted to come up this way and explore some of this region and finish up Glacier Creek and over a very dramatic place called Scimitar Pass. Another great resource for planning that I like to use is either Google Earth or something like Bing Maps. And this shows some of the areas that we're really interested in. Here's that southern section of the Black Divide. This is called the Devil's Crags, and this is the line we were hoping to ski. It's not going to tell us how much snow is actually in there. So an important part of the preparation is to check the local avalanche advisory.
For this trip, our weather forecast was for high winds, then a nice day, followed by 3 days of light snow showers and some unstable weather. We knew the weather would play a major role in what we'd be able to accomplish on this trip.
And the next thing to do is just to figure out who's coming. Who do you want to join you on your itinerary? And in this case, my friend Glen Plake was saying he was up for an adventure. So this is definitely an adventure. We're heading way out there into the wilderness where few people have ever skied. And we're looking forward to some exploration and some unknowns. Okay, I'm getting packed now for a 5-day trip, and a lot of people ask me, including him, how do you pack for a 5-day trip? How do you go as light as possible? Keep your gear functional without carrying too much, but making sure that you have all the essentials that you need.
When ski mountaineering in remote areas, it is important to go light, but also to be self-reliant, able to facilitate your own safety and enjoyment. This means carrying the essentials without weighing yourself down. Too much weight will have a major impact on the quality of your experience. On the other hand, not having what you need can end the trip very quickly. Strive to carry the lightest gear that will do the job. Try to bring items that may have multiple uses. Create systems that work together to reduce weight and bulk. Ski packs work best when they're smaller and more compact. I was able to put all these items for 5 days into a 40-liter pack. Cooking and sleeping systems are commonly overweight. Bring instant cook-in-the-cup style meals rather than food items that take cooking in the pot. This reduces pot size and fuel requirements and also eliminates the hassle of doing the dishes. This cooking system enables a lightweight sleeping system. We cook in a well-ventilated, floorless tent. This allows us to easily use our sleeping bags for warmth while cooking and melting snow. The stove and our bodies provide warmth in the tent. Our clothing is warm while sleeping. This enables us to bring super light and compressible down sleeping bags. This reduction of bulk allows us to use a smaller and lighter backpack. It all works together.
Maybe I'll take him with me too. He's only 15 pounds. Here we are. top of the road, 9,800 feet, South Lake. And we're getting ready for a 5-day trip. Mr. Glen Plake over here, getting set up. Our packs weigh about 35 pounds each, so we're feeling pretty good about it. And off into the windstorm. Here we are, end of day one. We made it, we're at camp. Let's check it out. Glen, doing a little maintenance. We got our tent, nice water source back there. Devil's Crags up above, Kings Canyon down below, and Palisade Creek. Yeah, perfect, huh?